Hey friends, welcome to Hot News. So this is actually experiment time because I don't know if you checked out the UFD Tech channel. We talked about how we were gonna be putting the main Hot News on that, and then this Hot News channel can either die or we could do what we did initially, which is the clips from certain episodes and just kind of make them as standalone videos, giving you 2 to 3 per day, depending on how much content is out there. So that is what we're trialing right now. So if you're watching this is probably coming out before the main channel Hot News on UFD Tech. So you're getting a sneak peek, little chipper whipper, as I like to not say anymore, ever. Let's get into it, which is Intel talked a lot at IFA about their upcoming new Cascade Lake architecture that should be coming out in October. This is going to be their high-end desktop chips, which will serve as a replacement for the Skylake X architecture that we've been on, which was the 7900 series. You had up to the 7980XE, which was 18 cores. Then they refreshed it. You had the 9980XE up to that. Well, now you're gonna get Cascade Lake. No official naming scheme, but it's gonna be on the LGA 2066 socket. I hope they don't call it like the 10900 series, like the 10980XE. That's too much, Intel. Don't do that. Anyways, what they're claiming, and the big reason why this is news, is that it's going to give you up to double the value of the previous generation Skylake X architecture. 1.74 to 2.09 times is what they're claiming in their size relative performance of value, performance per dollar is what they're quoting, compared to Skylake X. In the chart, Intel also gives credence to the fact that Threadripper tends to be a better performance per dollar. 2990WX, the 32-core chip, is 1.3 times better than the Skylake X. You got the 2970, 1.47 times, and then the 16-core 2950X coming in at 1.6 times. So even the lowest end Cascade Lake should beat out the best value Threadripper chip when it comes to performance per dollar, at least according to Intel. Obviously, that take that with a huge grain of salt since this is Intel's presentation, but it's a good indication. The new Cascade Lake X architecture will likely only have up to 18 cores according to Intel, so it's not gonna try to beat an AMD on freaking core count whatsoever. But at the same time, this is not taking into account any sort of refresh for the Threadripper chips that we're expecting from AMD. And in case you don't remember, Lisa Su, when being asked in interviews regarding Threadripper 3000, she's been less than able to commit regarding those chips, indicating that there will be more information out about them this year, but not quite ready to actually say whether or not they're coming out this year, which to me indicates that they'll talk about it later this year and then release them early next year. So probably CES could be a potential launch date, or more towards the first and second quarter of next year. Could even be Computex for that matter. But with Cascade Lake X launching next month, Intel will actually potentially get the jump on Threadripper 3000 and could make some decent high-end desktop sales in the meantime until AMD can produce Zen 2 high-end desktop chips in the Threadripper 3000 region. And again, this is all based on Intel's own internal charts, or external now that they debuted this at IFA. So take this for what you will, but Intel coming in with 2 times the performance per dollar than their previous generation, which actually is a decent improvement, even if it's taken us 3 years to get there. Okay, that's the end of this little Hot News clip. Be sure to hit the like button if you enjoyed this video. Get subscribed to Hot News for more clips and potential anything else that we do in the meantime. I'm Brett, bye. Never mind.